The name angiosperm itself means seed within a vessel. Also known as the flowering plants, angiosperms carry their female gametes, or ovules, within the ovary of their flowers. Upon fertilization, the flower wilts, and the ovary becomes the fleshy fruit. Here you can see the seeds, the fertilized ovules, harbored within the ovary of the tomato fruit, with the sepals at the top of the fruit. But not all flowering plants have colorful flowers. Many have tiny flowers. The angiosperm phylum is divided into two classes, the monocotyledons, or the monocots, and the dicotyledons, or the dicots. Today we examine three differences between monocots and dicots. The cotyledon itself forms the bulk of the seed, storing significant amounts of food. But upon germination, the paired cotyledons rise above the surface of the ground in dicots, whereas in monocots, the single cotyledon remains within the soil. Other differences include branching patterns of the veins in the leaves, with monocots having parallel venation and dicots having branched veins. Another difference lies in the root structure, with dicots having tap roots and monocots having significant prop or support roots known as adventitious roots. A fourth and very significant difference lies in the internal structure of the monocot and dicot. If we were to make a transverse section through a monocot and dicot stem, we would be able to observe characteristic patterns for the arrangement of the vascular bundles. The vascular bundle is a specific portion of the stem that carries the xylem vessels for transporting water and mineral salts, and the phloem vessels for transporting sucrose to all parts of the plant. In dicots, these vascular bundles are arranged in a definite pattern along the periphery of the stem, whereas in monocots, the vascular bundles are scattered throughout the stem.